around 14, 15. I don't think I was 16. Number of young people, young men particularly, 18, 19, 20, who had finished high school and were just sort of walking the streets, and that's one thing that I remember, the number of the young people who had finished high school and were looking for jobs to get the started on their career.
Well, my most vivid memory is hearing my father tell my mother that he didn't have to go to work anymore until they called him. That was pretty sad news.
What it was all about was that you lived in that particular time, and that there really was not, we didn't have anything. Like, we didn't have running water. Hmm. We didn't have hot water. We didn't have a fridge. We didn't have a television. We didn't have a radio. We didn't have a telephone. And how many other things didn't we have?
I got my degree in music, and I wanted to further my musical studies, especially singing, which I was a singer. And I wanted to go to New York City, and that was Depression times. Everyone said, you can't go to New York. There are 70,000 girls streaming into New York every day looking for work. And I said, I don't need 70,000 jobs. I only need one, and I'll find it. And I got offered three.
And I worked at all kinds of jobs during the Depression, because I started work in 1929, just as the Depression started. So I worked for a while there, and then that folded, and I worked odds and ends all through the Depression.
I think in many ways the Depression was good for us who grew up at that time, because we learned the value of a dollar. We learned how to economize and how to live carefully.
It's amazing what you learn to do without the vacations, the clothing. You go back in a way to the simple things in life, and everything is, all the things that are enjoyable are very often free.
I've always been extremely optimistic, and I still am, and I never think anything is going to lick me. I think I always feel that there's something better ahead. And I used to say I didn't worry a lot. It wasn't my nature to worry. I'd say if there was a big problem, I'd just pull the blind down in front of the problem and forget about it and carry on. And I think you just have to have faith and believe that things are going to turn out all right. And in my case, things bounced back, and they did for other people too. It took a while, didn't it?